it's me, Meru. Today I wanted to talk about 5 things that helped me survive Japanese winter. Japanese winter is, I guess, a bit of a broad term. I live in Tokyo, so it's kind of one of the milder winters. There's obviously winters in Hokkaido, which is in the north of Japan, and there's winters in Okinawa, which are not really very wintry at all, so there's like a broad spectrum, but obviously I'm just going to talk about Tokyo. Winters in Tokyo aren't that long, maybe 3-4 months at most, and they're quite dry. And the temperature is about minus a few degrees, minus 5 would probably be really cold, but let's say like around 0. So I'll start with the first of the 5 things, which is air conditioning. Ta-da! So in Tokyo, most people warm their apartments with air conditioning. So the air conditioner isn't just for summer, making cooler, it's also used in winter for making hot air. And in England, we almost never use an air conditioner anywhere. Like even in summer, only like shops and offices really have an air conditioner for summer. But in winter, we definitely don't use this for heating. So it's something I only really started to use after I came and lived in Japan. And there are other ways to heat houses in Japan generally, like this underfloor heating. But for Tokyo, this is enough. However, as I just mentioned, winter in Japan is pretty dry, and heating just the air with an air conditioner makes the air even drier. So item number 2 on my list of things I survive winter with in Japan, which is the humidifier. We actually have 2 humidifiers. This one that blows steam at like 40 something degrees, 42 I think it was max, and another humidifier which is attached to our air cleaner, and that one you can't see. Like it just raises the humidity without any visible vapor. I couldn't imagine bringing this back to the UK though, because although humidifiers do exist in the UK, England is like year round. That is not nice. England is like year-round humid-ish. It's definitely not dry in the UK. So you definitely wouldn't need this in winter. Actually, in my house in the UK, we have dehumidifiers in winter, especially because things get moldy and we dry our clothes indoors because it's too cold outside, and like I said, it's humid. So we don't dry our clothes outside that much in winter either. So inside in winter in England is quite humid. So in my house in England, we have dehumidifiers. The third item on my list is in the shower room. So this is the panel that controls it, but the thing I'm talking about is actually up there. That thing on the ceiling is controlled by this panel, and it has multiple uses. Like you can dry clothes in this room, which you can do on rainy days, which is great, but the main feature I'm talking about for winter is this danbu. But on cold days in winter, I love this danbu setting because I could warm up like this space, and yet really helped face the fears of getting naked in winter when it's so cold. If I move back to England, I really want to have this. イギリスでユニットバースが少ないとかない? だからこのものは見たことない。イギリスで。特にこれはすごくいいのが、その洗濯物干せる。それもすごくいい。それ欲しい。さっき言った通りに、イギリスだと冬だと服はただ家の中に干す。だけどそれですごい湿度が上がるから、まあこういうものあったらそれもすごく便利だと思う。Now the 4th thing on my list of things that I used to survive Tokyo winter is again the lovely toilet. But specifically, the heated seat function. In Japan, toilet seats are heated. Not everywhere, but pretty much everywhere I've been. So that in winter when you sit down, you don't have like a shock of the seat being cold, which I was so used to for like my whole life. And sometimes I still sit on seats like that in Tokyo, but it's quite rare. But oh my goodness, it's so nice. And like when you sit on a cold seat now, it's like, how did I do this for like 20 something years? I want my heated toilet seat. Nah, あったかい na, 最高. And also like, I think it depends on the toilet seat, but the one we have, there's at least 3 levels of heat. So in summer, you can either turn it off or you can have it on the lowest setting. And in winter, you can turn it up to the nice level 3 setting. And it's really nice and hot when you sit on it, which I think is pretty cool. Nah, なんか時々駅のトイレそれじゃない時にで駅そもそもそんなに暖かくないからなるんじゃん駅で Japanese toilets are super famous and I think they're mainly famous for the washlet function but this is also like one of the super great points of Japanese toilets And the fifth thing that I couldn't survive Japanese winter without is the kairo! Yay! So the kairo is an item that you don't use at home, you use it outside. You might use it at home, but generally outside. And the type I like the most is this haranai. Another type of kairo, which is really common in Japan, which is sticky on one side. First of all, what is a kairo? Kairo って何? 本当に。不思議なもの。カエロだけ言ったら、このカタカナ言葉英語じゃないからね、それってなる。A kairo is a hot pack, basically. It's the type where you open it and then it gets exposed to the air and it starts like a chemical reaction and it gets hot. 何度になりますか?40度以上になる。for 20時間。max 68度。And this is super helpful for putting in your pocket when you're outside to warm up your hands.On a cold winter's day, and if you have the haru type, you're not supposed to, but you can stick it to your clothing, like underneath. It's not supposed to touch direct skin because it's obviously quite hot. This one I love because I like to hold it. When I was a child in England, we had hot packs, but it wasn't like this. Like, これすごく便利なんか簡単だから。私子供の時に使ってたものはこの系じゃなくて透明のエキスだった。の、なんか丸いパワーポーチとかまあいろんな形もあったなんか可愛い系のやつもあったでなんかボタンが入ってたなんかメタルのボタンでそれをクリックすると急になんかウェーブみたいに白くなってたで硬くなったあのものがでそれが熱くなったでそれをなんか一日中持ってで家に帰ったらボイリングして戻ってたで、もう一回透明になって、で、なんか、ジェリーパックみたいな感じになった。それは子供の時にあった。で、そんなにたくさん使ってたわけではない。なんか、ちょっとめんどくさい点もある。なんか、リセットし忘れてたら、もう使えないじゃない。だから、それはの方が、なんか、使いやすいと思ってる。すごい楽しいね。カイロ大好き。すっごいでかい箱買った。特に北海道に行った時にいっぱい持ってきた。One of the other good things about kairo is not just when it's cold, but if you have like period cramps or something, you can like stick it to your clothing here or something, and it can help with the cramps, just like a hot water bottle does. So there's lots of different ways to use it. I also like to use my kairo from the end of the day. If it's still warm, I put it in my bed and warm the bed before I go to sleep. So when I get into bed, it's nice and warm.残り暑さを使ってる。なんか20時間長いじゃん。昼間に飽きたら、まだ夜、なんか寝るときにまた使えるから、いいベッドウォーマーになります。これもカイロじゃない?なんでカピバラ。そのなんか温泉にいる、あったかいってみたいな感じでタオル置いてるんでしょ。カイロじゃないな。俺考えたことないけど、このカピバラ何やってんの?これ私思ってるのはいいお土産と思ってるイギリスに持って帰るなんか家族にあげる面白いと思う便利ね Those were five items that I used to survive winter in Tokyo, Japan There's probably some more so let me know in the comments if you have any ideas And if you like this video leave it a like Subscribe if you haven't already And I'll see you in the next video Bye bye